Hi, my name is Rick Eads, and I am a senior product manager for Keysight Technologies. Today I'll be talking to you about some PAM4 measurements that are made or performed on a real-time oscilloscope. So let me talk to you a little bit about our setup here. We have a Keysight Z-Series 63 gigahertz oscilloscope, and we're using our real-edge channels that have full bandwidth out to 63 gigahertz. To receive a signal, a PAM4 signal, that's operating at 28 gigabaud, or 28 gigasymbols per second. Now, PAM4 is a little bit different than a classical NRZ type signal, where the symbol rate essentially equates to what the bit rate is. Now, in the case of PAM4, we're transmitting symbols, and each symbol has 2 bits. So by transmitting 28 gigabaud, or gigasymbols per second, we're actually transmitting 56 gigabit. So I'm going to go back and hit default setup and go back to just a straight PAM4 signal. So you've seen the baseline measurements that we have, where we can deal in the context of PAM4. We can also, once we've specified this, we can also add CTLE, we can add DFE. All of those capabilities for equalization are tuned to the needs of a PAM4 signal. So we've enhanced the overall software to be able to comprehend the requirements that are necessary when you're working with PAM4. So the next thing I want to do is to show you that, given that baseline collection of measurements that we have, the next thing Keysight has done is to take those and adapt those to some specific requirements that are being called out in some of the IEEE and the CEI specifications for signal technologies that utilize PAM4. So we have this application on the real-time scope and on our DCA series of scopes. On the real-time scopes, it's referred to as the N8836A, Pulse Amplitude Modulation 4 application for making PAM4 measurements. So here we have 2 different standards that we can select, for example, either PAM4 under the IEEE standard or under the PAM4 OIF standard. And we're using the real edge signals. And here I'll go into the different tests that we can do. So now all of these tests are referenced specifically to the standard that you choose. So we have, for example, tests of the output voltage levels. We have output waveform measurements, eye width, eye height measurements, differential peak voltage output measurements, jitter measurements that are all tied directly to the specification. So we know that a lot of these specifications are still in the development process, so this software will become enhanced over time, but we wanted to provide you with something that you can use today to essentially do the best analysis and characterization of your PAM4 signals according to these specifications. Once we have these set up, we'll go into our configure space, we'll specify that they're operating with a 28 gigabit per second signal, we'll connect the signal into the scope, tell it how it's connected, and then we click on Run Tests. We've started from just a basic signal going in to PAM4, and the application will go through the process of scaling those signals. It will go through the process of creating the differential where needed, or dealing with the single-ended components of the signal to look at common mode measurements, for example. And then it will produce an HTML report for the analysis once it's completed. So now you can see it's the software itself has rendered the PAM4i, and it's attempting to assign or determine what the proper levels are for this particular signal that we're driving into the scope. And then once it has those levels established, it will go on and complete the measurements that we requested in the setup page as we selected them. So a couple of things about PAM4 is that having a high bandwidth scope can be extremely useful, because some of the standards require that you use a fourth order Bessel-Thompson filter that you apply to the signal. So this generally assumes you've got a Gaussian response in this oscilloscope itself. So by using a high bandwidth scope like our 63 gigahertz oscilloscope, we can achieve a Gaussian response that comprehends the requirements of the PAM4 specifications, as you have that gradual roll-off and include all of the higher frequency components of the PAM4 signal that you're trying to measure with the application. And as it's going through now, it's completing the measurements. So now everything has been completed. So we'll go to the HTML report, and you can see that the report has collected all of the data from the test that we selected. It's pulled out the eye width, eye height measurements, as well as captured the screenshots. So here's a brief overview of the capabilities that we have available in our Keysight Infinium series real-time oscilloscopes for PAM4. I'm very pleased that I've had this time to spend with you. And if you have any questions, please contact us and use the links that are provided below in this video. Thank you.